In this video, we will discuss other characteristics of a main data collection instrument, including enabled and hidden questions, error messages, comments, translations, and the overall navigation in the application. The cover page displays identifying information about the current questionnaire, such as interview key, assignments number, title of the questionnaire, supervisor notes, list of the questions with the supervisor comments, and identifying questions. The interview key helps you identify the questionnaire and could be useful in the case of some problems with the current interview. To view the comments, press on any listed questions with supervisor comments, and you'll be redirected to the question with the relevant comment. Review the information and make sure everything is correct, and then click on the blue Start button at the bottom of the screen to start the interview. Anytime during the interview, you can switch the language of the interview if it's available. To do that, tap on the menu button on the top right and select language. Choose a language from the pop-up menu. Some questions and sections throughout the questionnaire will be disabled and/or hidden in the questionnaire based on information you've provided. However, these disabled and/or hidden questions may become enabled as you answer more questions. For example, consider this plot roster, which will be enabled if the respondent reports that maize has been grown on the parcel. However, do note that at times the disabled questions, roster, or section can be hidden. For example, the plot area question in the plot roster is not shown until it is enabled by answering yes to the question on whether or not maize is grown on the plot. All enabled questions must be answered. After an answer is recorded, the interviewer application automatically assesses whether the answer is consistent with other answers in the questionnaire or plausible based on what is known about the survey population. If an answer is inconsistent or unlikely, that answer is considered invalid. Questions with invalid answers are outlined in red and are accompanied by an error message. For example, the harvest of crop day should be before the year of the date the interview was started. Please note that an invalid question does not necessarily mean that the answer is wrong, as in our example. If an invalid answer is indeed a wrong answer, check your work. If an invalid question has a correct answer, please leave an explanatory comment for your supervisor. Comments can be left for any question. This may be useful to explain answers that you have confirmed, but that may appear strange or wrong to your supervisor. To leave a comment, press for a moment on the question of interest. After a few seconds, a comment field will appear, into which you can type any arbitrary long comment. Comments can also be left for you by your supervisor. These will likely be questions about the answers you have recorded. Comments for each question will appear next to the commented questions. Warnings are the same as error messages, but answers aren't considered as invalid. This message is showing that you should pay more attention and check the given answer. The navigation pane, in addition to being a table of contents for the questionnaire, provides valuable information on the interview progress. Tap the button on the upper left-hand side to open the navigation pane. The navigation pane displays which sections and subsections are complete, which are incomplete, and which contain errors. Green denotes complete. Blue indicates incomplete or errors deeper in a given section or subsection of the questionnaire. Red flags errors in the immediate section or subsection. On the tablet, both rosters and groups first appear as a button. Once answers are recorded for the roster source question, the applicable roster rows are created. For example, suppose you're answering a household member list question that is the source question for the household roster. As you enter the household member names in the list question, a button for each household member is created. When the button is tapped, you will see the questions or roster row associated with that button. To exit the roster row, you must select the roster row button at the bottom of the screen. To complete a group or roster, you must answer all relevant questions. For a group, this is simple. For a roster, the process merits some explanation. A roster must be completed row by row. In the household roster example, you must tap on the button associated with any given person to answer all questions for that individual in the roster. To move back to the roster view, tap on the roster button at the bottom of the screen. You should follow the survey protocol strictly, meaning that you should ask earlier questions before later questions, completing earlier modules before later modules. You may nevertheless need to move around the questionnaire to review your work, move rows of the roster if the respondent corrects an earlier answer, or administer an independent module when the key respondent for that module is present. To move within a section, swipe up and down to move within a single group of questions. To move between any sections, use either the breadcrumbs or the navigation pane to move between sections. The breadcrumbs, represented as links at the top of the screen, are used to move between different groups of questions and subsections of the module. These pieces of the interface are meant to help you find the path back to where you were in the interview. Suppose you are in a group of questions about the maze, the title shown at the top of the screen. That group of questions falls within Plot, Maze, Sweet Potato, the next breadcrumb, which itself falls inside the Parcel and Plot Details module. To move from the maze section to the Plot, Maze, Sweet Potato section, tap on the Plot, Maze, Sweet Potato breadcrumb. To move to the main part of the Parcel and Plot Details module, from either the Plot, Maze, Sweet Potato or the maze sections, tap on the Parcel and Plot Details link. Refer to the navigation pane to check on the interview progress, which sections and subsections are complete, which are incomplete, and which contain errors, using the colors to quickly identify possible problem areas. Once you're satisfied with the questionnaire and are ready to set the questionnaire as complete, navigate to the system-generated section named Complete for that questionnaire. In that section, you'll see the number of completed questions, number of unanswered questions, and the number of invalid questions, meaning questions with answers that have triggered error messages. Two important points to remember are, 1. Use these system-generated statistics to confirm that all questions have been answered and all answered questions have valid answers. 2. You see the same statistic that the supervisor does. Therefore, your supervisor will see any problems with your work immediately. After first completing and then checking your work, mark the interview as complete. You can leave an optional comment to your supervisor regarding the interview overall, such as highlighting a set of problems, explaining an issue that arose, and how it was resolved, etc. Aside from learning the topics covered in the interviewer training videos, field practice is the single most important training activity. Start practicing and spend as much time preparing as you can. The more practice you have, the easier and more surprise-free fieldwork will be. For more information, please visit our site.